Brian Crabtree here, HouseDog.com, the real estate experts, with a housing update. Some news this morning floating around that's got some fodder going on Facebook, that Biden, President Biden, to target rent gouging landlords as high housing costs factor, as they say, in the 2024 presidential race. Now, I don't want to get into the politics of this, but there are some key factors that are floating around the entire real estate market. Lack of supply. Let's start there. The lack of supply in the housing market, in my opinion, is greatly related to the fact that there's been so much construction diverted toward apartments. A million apartments across the country in some phase of construction. I joke in Mount Pleasant here in South Carolina that we need more apartments here, like we need a hole in the head. They're going up kind of everywhere. But here's the plan. They want to target landlords that he claims, President Biden, are keeping rents artificially high. His attack on rent gouging seeks to shift the blame for the high housing costs partly onto the corporate landlords, part of the broader campaign. This according to CNBC. Housing costs, a top issue for voters heading into Biden's November rematch against Donald Trump. Well, here's the thing. The housing cost in our country are greatly a result of the lack of inventory. So there's roughly about a million people right now who, if interest rates were lower and there were more inventory across the country, would buy a house. And because they're not capable of buying, they are renting. And when there is a surge in demand in renting and the rental supply hasn't caught up yet, especially the corporate landlords, what we're seeing is they do what's called everyday pricing. And so if there are 100 people out shopping today using all kinds of analytics for a three-bedroom apartment in Somerville, South Carolina, or Mount Pleasant, South Carolina, and there are 14 units actively available on the market, the price goes up. And by contrast, if the demand drops and there's a surge of new inventory, which happens a lot of times in the winter, then they drop the rate. So what's happened is that with analytics and the data science of our age, the traditional corporate landlords have gotten really smart about how to drive up and maintain high rental prices. So this is a problem for the housing market. One of the biggest problems I see with corporate landlords and corporate money is there's been a diversion of billions and billions of dollars that's been put into developing multifamily residential properties. And we're not developing condominium complexes at a rate. It's alarming, actually. We're not converting condos anymore like we did 15 or 20 years ago, apartments into condos. We're not seeing apartment buildings of the higher quality sell in a lot of the markets, places like Somerville and Monk's Corner and Charleston and Hanahan, where there's been North Charleston. There's been a lot of development of luxury apartment complexes. But those are the types of spaces that we saw 20 and 30 years ago where they were developing condos and townhomes. Now they're going for more dense, hedge fund type money, corporate landlord money. And that's driven, at least for now, as that development catches up to household creation, has driven the prices of rents up. I predict, however, that rent rates over the next 5 years are going to seek and find some sort of humbling demise. They've gone up so much that the entry level one bedrooms at a place like Mount Pleasant are now in the 2,000 and up range. We're already seeing some of the higher end stuff that got up to $4,000 and $5,000 for a three bedroom. We've seen some of that come down. So as more of these apartments hit the market, I think we're going to find that the Biden plan to attack corporate landlords will just be unnecessary because they've built too much supply. And I hope and I think that will be good for the housing market, because as the development and construction of property becomes less attractive for multifamily over the next 5 years or so, as all of this inventory, million units, hits the market, that will drive the prices down, make it less attractive for investment. We're already seeing that trend start, and we'll get more supply in the housing market, which is desperately needed. If you need a home equity checkup to find out where your home equity is your home equity safe? Are you thinking about buying? You need to get pre-approved for a mortgage. We are looking at the possibility of interest rates dipping below 6%, according to Fannie Mae, by the third to fourth quarter of this year. So now is the time, if you're thinking about buying in the next year, to get ready, get pre-approved, get your credit score up with a, with some you know, really good strategic moves in your credit report. Get that looked at now and then be ready to take advantage of the market before these rates go down and prices start going up even more, because prices, even with high interest rates, are still going up. HouseDog.com, you can reach out to me or just Brian, B-R-Y-A-N, Brian at HouseDog.com. Thanks for watching.